Okay, mooing. This is another method which helps us to understand or to have an result or conclusion in order to select the different among the different alternatives existing for us in terms of selecting the right facility of location. So it is factor rating method. Okay. So this method involves qualitative and quantitative inputs and evaluates alternatives based on comparison after establishing a composite value for each alternative. So here this is again qualitative and quantitative inputs. It's again the same, qualitative in the sense the skilled labor, that is always involved, or say analysis based on the quality of the in the quality of the labors. And quantitative is where you can quantify it in number of units, which is the numbers being produced, or the market share, all this elements, or say raw materials being involved. So the everything, these are the so this is a method which helps us to understand based on the qualitative and quantitative inputs being involved in the production system. Okay, so this is how, let's see first, if we look at the steps on what this method is being drawn, so that will be easy for us to understand. So first one is, as a part of this factor rating method, so we need to, we have different factors involved have an impact on the selection of location of our manufacturing unit. So first, as a manufacturing unit, we need to list down the relevant factors which are much important for us as business unit. So first are the basic step, as analysis, we have to list down the relevant factors for our manufacturing unit, or say a business unit. Then assign an importance weight as unity. So I've taken, you can see, so 1 to 100, you can whatever the number you can use and rate it. Okay, so first is you have to rate your each factor. You have to give the weightage. So how much is important for you? Based on that, you need to rate. Say I would, that will be easy to understand when we go back to, when you go into the numbers when we see. Okay, so first thing is we have to list down the relevant factors for us. Second is assign importance weight. Weight in the sense, what is the weightage or what is the importance is for you with respect to that factor. Okay, so moving ahead, okay, we have make a sum of weight as unity. So I said 1 to 5 is your number which you're going to assign between 1 to 5, and then you will be make a sum of that unity, so make a sum of weight or what you have assigned to the factors, and then set a scale for scoring each factor. So here we need to give a feedback, or see somewhere we receive feedback, rate the feedback between 1 to 10, 1 to 5. Like the same way, we need to rate, or we need to give the scoring pertaining to the different localities or the different alternatives with respect to plant location. Okay, we need to set the scale for scoring each. Say for this example, I've taken from 1 to 10. So for depending upon the factors, what you have chosen, what are relevant for you, based on that, you will be assigning the weightage, and then you will be assigning score for them or a scale for them, and then you will be score each location using a factor scale. Okay, so you have assigned a scale for your factors, you have given a weight for your factors, and then you have given the scores for your different alternatives, and then multiplied. So next point is multiply score by weights for each factor and then add to get the correct data, which helps us to in selecting the right location. So then last is select the location with the maximum score. See, in cost volume analysis, we selected which is less, because that is cost which says that particular location is less, so we get all the economic benefits. But in factor rating method, your rating scale, you're giving the score based on your importance, or considering that is important in that is availability more in that particular alternative. Based on that, you will be giving score. So I'll just repeat once again the steps in order to give the rating for your factors which are relevant to your organization, and based on that you will be selecting the different alternatives available. Okay, first one is relevant, list down all the relevant factors to you and assign the important weightage, or you know, you scale it. This is what is important, and you weigh that. Okay, and then make a sum of weight as a unity and set a scale for scoring each factor. So you need to score the each factor which is important for you, or say according to the survey you feel this is in this particular location, the availability of this factor or this is very much more, so you would rate that. So based on that you will be doing, and then score each location using factor scale, multiply score by ways for each factor and add, and then select the location with the maximum score. So let's see this. Let's understand factor rating method with the help of this table, where we have the data with the three different plant location A, B and C. According to the step, let's go back to the previous slide to look into the relevant steps in order to factor rating method. So according to the steps, we have to list down the basic step is we have to list down the relevant factors for us as on basis on what product or what system we are into, a manufacturing system, which industry. So everything we need to keep in mind, and we have to list down the relevant factors with the particular industry and product base. And then every product has to see. So now in a chat you can see that I have listed down with the list of different factors. If you to look into factor, the proximity to market, and I have listed down as supply of market, transportation of facilities, infrastructure availability, labor and wages. These are the any basic requirements in terms of factors, or which has an effect in the selection of plant location. Okay, let's see. And what is the second step? See, assign importance weight as the unity. So here I have taken between 1 to 5. So the second point is you need to give an importance, or you need to weight your factors pertaining to your importance. So which factor you're going to give more importance in order to settle down or set up your plant. So I have given more importance, the more weightage to proximity to markets, and moving ahead 1.5 with supply of material, and then labor wages, and then transportation facilities, and then infrastructure availability. So this is what is the weightage I have given. And then third point is make a sum of weight as unity. So here we need to make a sum when we are allocating the weightage or the importance to the factors. We need to make sure we rate a number where we can sum up as, you know, where we can have a sum of all these weightage. So between 1 to 5 I have considered. So here in this way I have assigned. So where I have the sum of 5. Okay. Moving ahead, next step is set a scale for scoring each factor. Okay. So here we have three different locations having three different set of impacts with the different factors. So here with the understand the location A, then we can apply the same on the other two locations as well. So then the cash, now we have to assign a score with respect to different factors. So pertaining on the certain survey or the data or the analysis what we have as a company. Okay, so we have to do all this prior analysis with respect to each location. Okay, so based on that survey or data we have this scoring, we have to rate, we have to give a score for each factor. So based on that, for location A I have scored proximity to market is 8. This is the scoring has been given between 1 to 10. Here you don't need to have a concept of summing up all the scales. You 1 to 10 you can give any the factor or the any score which you feel feasible for that particular factor. Okay, so with respect to supply of raw material, I have given score of 10, and with respect to transportation facilities, I have given 7, and infrastructure availability, I have given 6, and labor and wages, I have given 3. So to get weighted score, we need to multiply weight is given to each factor and the score given to each location. So with the example of location, if we multiply to get the weighted score for proximity to market, it is 2 multiplied by 8, we get 16. The same way, The supply of raw materials, it is 1.5 to 10, multiplied by 10 is 15. For transportation facilities, if multiplied by 0.5 into 7, it is 3.5. Infrastructure availability is 0.25 into 6. We get a wages score of 1.5. Labor and wages, 0.75 into 3, we get 2.25. So this is the score we got for individual factor. When we sum up with these factors, or when we make a sum of, when we add this all the weighted score, we get total weighted score, which is the main element for our decision element. Okay, so same way we have to apply it for location B and location C. Individual allocate individual score for each factors, and then get a weighted score, and then we summarize in order to get the total weighted score. Same way it is for C. Okay, so now if we observe the table, the highest score is with location A. So now location B has 32.75 and location C is 34 together. So now the lowest is location B and the second highest is 34, and the last highest is, the first highest is location A, second highest is location C, and third highest is location B. So now what our method says is select the location with the maximum score. So we have to select suitable, we have to select a location which has more weighted score, or which has the highest weighted score. So based on this, so according to this illustration, if we have to select among these three locations, location A is suitable for us to go ahead with the planned selection. So this was all about the factor rating method.